Now we are going to see the expression for phase margin. So the open loop transfer function of the second order system is nothing but g of s is equal to omega n square divided by s into s plus 2 zeta omega n. So this is nothing but the open loop transfer function, not the closed loop transfer function. So the open loop transfer function g of s is equal to omega n square divided by s into s plus 2 zeta omega n. So the sinusoidal transfer function g of j omega is obtained by putting s is equal to j omega. Wherever you are having s, you have to replace it by j omega. So g of j omega is equal to omega n square divided by j omega into j omega plus 2 zeta omega n. So after that, we are taking omega n common from these two terms, and then we are adding and multiplying a omega n. Okay, so here you are having an omega n, here you are having an omega n, both gets cancelled, and we are getting 1 divided by j omega by omega n into 2 zeta plus j into omega by omega n. Now we are going to take u is equal to omega by omega n. It is nothing but normalized frequency. U is nothing but normalized frequency, that we are taking it as omega by omega n. Now we are going to substitute u is equal to omega by omega n in equation 1. So we are getting g of j omega is equal to 1 divided by j u into 2 zeta plus j u. Now we are going to calculate the magnitude. This j u can be taken as 0 plus j u, and this is nothing but 2 zeta plus j u. Now we are going to calculate the magnitude. So this magnitude of the first term is nothing but 0 square plus u square, and the magnitude of the second term is nothing but root square root of 2 zeta the whole square plus u square. So this is nothing but your magnitude. Okay, so when you are taking this u inside the square root, it will become u square. So 4 zeta u square plus u to the power 4. So while rewriting, you will be getting 1 divided by square root of u to the power 4 plus 4 zeta square u square. So this is equation 2. Now we are going to calculate the angle. So this term is present in the numerator. So a minus for j u, the angle is 90 degree. For the second term, since it is present in the denominator, it is minus tan inverse of u divided by 2 zeta. This is nothing but the phase. Okay. This is equation 3. Now at gain crossover frequency, the magnitude of g of j omega is unity. Now we are taking the normalized gain crossover frequency as UGC. UGC is equal to omega GC by omega N. Now we are substituting UGC in equation 2 and we are equating it to unity. So we will be getting 1 divided by square root of u to the power 4 GC plus 4 zeta square UGC square is equal to 1. Where cross multiplying, you will be getting square root of u to the power 4 gc plus 4 zeta square u square is equal to 1. While squaring both sides, you will be getting u to the power 4 gc plus 4 zeta square u square is equal to 1. Now you are bringing this minus 1 to the left hand side, then you are taking ugc square is equal to x, and this is a quadratic equation, and while solving the quadratic equation, the roots are x is equal to minus 2 zeta square plus or minus root of 4 zeta to the power 4 plus 1. So we are taking only the positive sign, so we will be getting x is equal to minus 2 zeta square plus root of 4 zeta to the power 4 plus 1. But UGC is nothing but root of x. So you have to take root of x, that is nothing but minus 2 zeta square plus root of 4 zeta to the power 4 plus 1 to the power 1 by 2. So if you put to the power 1 by 2, it is nothing but equal to square root. So phase margin is nothing but 180 degree plus angle of g omega at omega is equal to omega gc. So we are substituting the angle g omega from equation 3 in the above equation. So you'll be getting phase margin is equal to 190 plus minus 90 minus tan inverse of UGC by 2 zeta. So now we are in the place of UGC, we are putting this value. So you will be getting face margin is equal to 90 minus tan inverse of minus 2 zeta square plus square root of 4 zeta power 4 plus 1 by 2 zeta the whole to the power 1 by 2. So this is nothing but the gain margin. So the gain margin of the second order system is infinite. So now we are going to find to summarize the expressions of frequency domain specifications. So resonant peak MR is nothing but is equal to 1 divided by 2 zeta into root of 1 minus zeta square, and normalized resonant frequency UR is equal to root of 1 minus 2 zeta square, and resonant frequency omega R is equal to omega n into root of 1 minus 2 zeta square. Bandwidth omega B is equal to omega n into 1 minus 2 zeta square plus square root of 2 minus 4 zeta square plus 4 zeta to the power 4 to the power 1 by 2. And phase margin is equal to 180 plus minus of 90 degree minus tan inverse of UGC by 2 zeta, that is equal to 90 minus tan inverse of minus 2 zeta plus root of 4 zeta to the power 4 plus 1 to the power 1 by 2 divided by 2 zeta. These are the expressions for frequency domain specification. So we will be using these expressions for doing the problems. So you must know all these terms. Okay.